I knew you'd come. Somehow I just knew you'd find me. Not knowing where I was or when I was coming back sent you crazy. I kept
hey, what's going on, YouTube family? If you're new here, welcome to the channel. My name is Mark, where I like talking all things music, news stories, and my own personal series, Mark Under the Microscope, where I give you an inside look as to who I am as a person through motivational and inspirational vlogging, because I had to grow up in a foster care system, and I never want you guys to have to feel like you have to navigate this world alone like I had to. So if you like things like this, please remember to slash that like button and annihilate that subscribe button and hit that post notification bell. I drop videos like this every Monday and Friday and every day in between. And also, leave me comments down below. I love interacting with you guys. And also, I do subscriber requests. So huge shout out to my subscribers out there. I love you guys. You know how much you guys mean to me, because without you, there would be no channel. So I think I've talked enough. Let's just jump straight into these videos. Let's go.
Point of view in this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, he's in her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, he's in her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, he's in her point of view. In this world where we grew, now here's his point of view. First of all, I hate the way you talk to me.
Oh, wow.
I fucking can't stand when you're in.
Hold on, I already love the way that this is starting off. So basically, I guess this is like a his and hers perspective of how, I guess maybe these two are in a relationship. So he's taking on her experience and she's probably gonna take on his experience when she basically starts talking. I definitely already think that this is a dope concept and I like what I'm seeing already. Let's jump back into this.
Ignoring me. It's like every day you wanna go to war with me. You're crying over spilt milk and trying to wipe the floor with me. Every time I ring you, your phone was in your bag. But every time I'm with you, your phone is in your hand. Yeah, I get annoyed and you say I'm paranoid. Then I'll send another message like I'll never phone you back. And why would you say cool to that if you ain't cool with that? You make me feel like it was all a plan. Like there's a man up in your yard and you're waiting for the chance to let a couple hours pass just to call me back. And you don't never sound the same when you're in the wrong. Kinda sound like you're staring down your intercom, just waiting for him to leave. Said you'll tell me if you did cheat and I'm breaking what we could be. So I'm getting.
And I gotta pause it right quickly because he's speaking straight facts. Like, when it's sometimes like when you're in a relationship, sometimes it's hard to admit when you're wrong. And certain people, like when you're going back and forth with each other, each one thinks that the other is right. And that causes a friction and a conflict within a relationship. But it's so much easier to sit there and just talk. But so many people would rather probably just leave and act like, oh, I don't want to be in that relationship no more, and just walk away instead of just sitting and talking things out and hashing out the problem and getting to the root of the problem. And I definitely like what he's sitting there saying and with his lyrics, because he's spitting the truth. Because people sit there oftentimes, like, they try to sit there and act like they're always right in a certain regard and in a certain situation. But I'm gonna rewind it a little bit to take it back.
Yeah, I get annoyed and you say I'm paranoid. Then I'll send another message like I'll never phone you back. And why would you say cool to that if you ain't cool with that? You make me feel like it was all a plan. Like there's a man up in your yard and you're waiting for the chance to let a couple hours pass just to call me back. And you don't never sound the same when you're in the wrong. Kinda sound like you're staring down your intercom, just waiting for him to leave. Said you'll tell me if you did cheat and I'm breaking what we could be. So I'm guessing it's make-believe. Still I don't believe you, but I'll run with it. If I'm out here keeping up some fuckery, just because I beat doesn't mean that you can beat. Cause two fucks don't make a right and it can never tarnish me. Sometimes I wonder.
He said two fucks don't make a right. Wow, that was deep. I like that. That was a dope bar. I like that.
If I've ever rocked your world, you care about your lashes and you care about your girls. Ooh. The one you're always chatting but she always does your nails. Talking about your fashion, it's gonna be YSL. Even though I think the dress couldn't be shorter, kinda makes me wonder how the fuck were you brought up. Ooh. Hearing conversations about your love for the ooh. Still I never listen cause I've done it with ooh ya. At the end of the month I always give you money, and at the end of the night I always give you love. And I have to state a few things and you don't have to change nothing. It's just my point of view, I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Isn't her point of of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, his and her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, his and her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, his and her point of view. In this world where we grew, now here's her point of view. I don't think that you respect me. I kinda think that you expect me to be here waiting for you, cause it's easier, cause we got a child together, went the extra mile together. But still there ain't a picture where we ever smile together. How many times do I have to say, how many times? I'm getting sick and I'm tired and I'm crying my eyes out, I don't know why. And then you've got the cheek to come and dry my eyes. Avoiding me don't mean jack.
And I love how he's taking the whole female perspective, and like he's given like an experience from the male perspective and then a female perspective, and now he's like jumping inside of the female body and telling the woman's side of the story of how she feels within the relationship. And I think that that is so deep and so dope, because a lot of times we always get like within these like type of like songs filled with substance, you only get this, and it deals with two varying perspectives, you only get the one side. But I like how he took time to put creative thought and genius into it to be able to give both sides of the story, to be like, okay, look, this is the man's side, but then there's also the woman's side as well. Like, and now we can just sit here and try to find a common ground, and I hope that's how he's gonna tie it up, where he comes back with like maybe a last segment where he ties it all together to find some type of commonality. I think that would be so sick and so dope. Let's jump back into this.
Back now, the toilet seat can go back down, and you can back down. You say your upbringing makes you never trust women. Well, it's funny how we're both from that background, and I trust you with my life, and you hit me twice, and both times I came back crying. I wish you knew the kitchen just like you know women. I wish you knew the dishes just like you know whipping. Between us, there's a big difference. I might reply to a DM, but you go the distance. Said I want a baby, you were scared I could tell. But when you slept with that hoe, you weren't protecting yourself, and that's disgusting. Imagine if you gave me something. Probably just say your favorite word, say nothing. And don't try and lie, because I know that it's true.
That is so true, because we are bred within society, and this is like a global aspect. Even though this is like, Wretch 3-2 is a UK artist, this is a global scale where men are believed to supposed to be these monolithic beings, and we are supposed to be void and lack emotion. I love how he just expressed that by giving the female perspective of sitting there saying like, oh, you're just gonna say nothing and just kind of like sweep it under the rug, because a lot of times that's how men deal with their emotions, because that's what we're ingrained and taught to do. That was very deep. I like that.
Cause one of your friends fucking telling on you. Plus the fact I could fucking smell it on you. You treat me like I'd never do better than you. If you left me on the floor, that's a step up from you. I don't know why love made me settle for you. At the end of the day, you know that you're my nigga. So at the end of the night, I've always got you dinner. I had to state a few things, even though you say I'm bitter. It's just my point of view, though you probably beg to differ. Isn't her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view, his and her point of view. In this world where we grew, this isn't her point of view.
Oh wow, and then just the imagery of the baby just there. Wow, that's crazy. We're gonna talk about this right after this. Let's go. This was deep. I like. So let's talk about this song with Wretch 32, his and hers perspectives. This was so creatively and masterfully done. It was so dope. I love the whole concept of this, because it was filled with so much substance, and this was like the type of song that I could really relate to, because as a child I had watched my mom in like so many abusive relationships, and like I mentioned in a past video of like how I actually witnessed my mom being raped multiple times as a child before I went into the foster care system. And just to hear how he spoke from the woman's perspective of about being inside of an abusive relationship really kind of hit home for me, because it made my ears perk up and made me want to listen more to what the perspective of what the woman had to say. Because like I said, a lot of times in songs like this of substance, you only get like the female perspective or you only get the male perspective. There's never like both sides of the story. But my only gripe
with this song would be, I wish that he would have came back for a third verse and made this video a little longer and came with a commonality where they were like battling back and forth of sitting there like having an exchange with each other, instead of like having one dedicated one verse directly to the man and one verse directly to the woman. I wish he would have came back for a third verse and sat there and had them going back and forth like it was like an exchange of them sitting there talking to each other, if that makes sense, if you get what I'm trying to say. Like having like a sort of dialogue, like trying to work out the issue of trying to resolve it instead of leaving it at the end. And that's it. Because like I said, a lot of times I feel like in relationships, the easiest thing for us to do is like leave, unless you really have to sit there and leave. Like if life or death depends on it, then I could see why. But like if it's like some like little thing that maybe you can work it out and just get over and like and see and try to come to like some common ground for the family and everything, then I could see about you staying and fixing the problem, but only then. But if it's like something like real serious, that's when I see that you can, that you walk away and just let it go. But I really like this video. It was filled with substance, and I cannot wait to react to more Wretch 3-2, because that was an awesome video. That was dope, and my hat goes off to him because that was genius. And that cinematography, I felt like I was watching like a real life love story movie. Just the cinematics of everything, the little still moments that they caught with the walking and her getting out the car and slamming the door, and just the anger and the emotion and the passion and the pain. Like you can really sense that he felt every word that he was saying. I thought that was incredible. So good job, good job, good job. I'm not going to rate this because, I mean, you can't rate artistic genius. I mean, there's some things that you just can't give a rating to, and that was genius. So please let me know what you thought in the comments below of this song. Also, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video, and also subscribe to the channel. And also, like I end every video out there, please remember to be safe out there. Remember to stay awesome, be awesome, because you guys are all awesome. This is your boy Mark, and I'm signing off. Deuces.
They need rappers like me. They need rappers like me, so they can get on their fucking keyboards and make me the bad guy, Chung Lee. Hey, yo, I've been-